Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco and today I'm going to be showing you this very cool and handy modeling technique on how you can pretty much model anything on a cylindrical surface with absolute maximum precision. I'm also going to be giving away some free pulls licenses, so stick around for, you know, on the rules how you can win something. So I'm going to be modeling this kind of candle holder thingy. What you can notice, it's cylindrical, you know, and it has these little, you know, flowers there and holes in them, but it also has this giant hole in the back. And now this giant hole is generally also like a pain in the ass to model, not to mention these, but I can show you how you can pretty much approach an object like that with like ultimate precision, and it's going to be actually super simple to do. So how do you go about modeling this? You're going to be modeling this on a flat plane, and then you're just going to put the bend around it, and that's pretty much it. But there is a catch. So look at this. So first thing that you need to do is go to circle, select a circle, make sure that the edge mode here is selected. And now we will generally measure the width of this whole thing with a circle. So I'm gonna make it like this. Then head over to utilities, click on the measure. And here you can see that the length of this shape is 22.4 centimeters. Now let's head over and create a plane. So plane is going to be as tall as my candle holder, but the width is going to be 22.4 centimeters. So now we got this. Now check this out. If I create a couple of segments here and a couple of segments there, right? The plan is model something onto this, then add a bend modifier, make it 360 on the X axis, and you pretty much got, you know, the shape from the picture. But you don't really have any control on what you're doing if you do it this way. So instead do this. Clone this object and clone it as a reference. Click OK. Now we got this object as an original object and this one, which is a reference. So this is how it works. You know, I got this object as a reference. There's a blue line here. Everything below the blue line is an instance and everything above the blue line is a reference. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna grab this bend and I'm gonna just pull it up and you see what happens. This object is a pure instance. This object has a reference, which is bend. And now I'm pretty much going to be modeling on this and I'm live going to see on this object what is actually happening. But there is a catch. So take a look at this. If I add edit poly here and let's say, you know, oppa, you see what's happening. Like if I'm selecting things and I'm just, you know, extruding stuff, something weird is happening here. So what is exactly happening? You are like with these selections, you are seeing the end result here, meaning you're pretty much seeing this, but through a selection, you know, and this is not ideal. So what do you want to do? Go to your object that has a reference, click on the blue line and add poly select. Now, when you add it poly select with the bend on top of it, look at this. You can now modify these things and, you know, this will kind of stay in place. So you'll pretty much get the idea on what you're doing. You know, like you can add stuff like this. You can now do various modifications, like add that, and you can perfectly see what's happening. So this way, you know, I'm going to be modeling a flower there, you know, this big hole there. And I'm going to instantly see here like a live feedback on how the model is actually looking finished. And I'm going to have absolute control over everything. So video is now going into a time-lapse mode, so buckle up. So now I'm at the stage where I generally modeled, you know, like this hole here. And since the photo that I'm using, it's not a planner, you know, photo, like it's not a planner candle holder. It's rounded. I'm actually looking at the perspective here. So what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to overlay my photo on top of my poly select bend, you know, object. And I'm going to actually see, you know, like how wide this thing really is compared to my object here. And what you can notice is you see like how my hole ends here, but the end is actually here. You know, I have to move these parts. So now this is very handy. I can just grab these, you know, kind of elements and I can just move them freely to just readjust my model. So you see like this, just move it around, try to kind of make it all work, make it all fit. So let's do it like this. Grab this one, you know, up to here and just, you know, do these little kind of adjustments to kind of match the whole perspective. And As you can see now, I generally got the shape. It's of course much wider than this, again, because I'm looking at, you know, a perspective object that's a cylinder. I don't see a flat thing. And now, as you can see, this is like the final hole that I made, and it actually perfectly matches, you know, the photo from the perspective, meaning that, you know, I actually gained some level of accuracy here. For the flowers, I'm generally just gonna model one flower and then, you know, as low poly as possible to kind of closely match the density of these polygons, and then I'm gonna just, you know, place it in, clone it, you know, two times extra, and hopefully everything will merge together. Oh, by the way, Pools has a Black Friday discount. Not only that they are discounting prices, they're also giving stuff for free. So Pools has a 25% off on Render Manager, Scene Manager, and Project Dream Pro. Not only that, whichever you purchase, you're gonna get 500 Project Dream credits. So how can you get these discounts? Use this code at the checkout and boom, the prices will drop. But hurry up, because their Black Friday discount is valid from November 22nd to December 2nd. But they're not only discounting things, they're actually giving things for free. So Pools is giving away for free 6 licenses. So they're giving away 3 Scene Managers and 3 Project Dream Pros. So Scene Manager is a 3-month license and a Project Dream Pro is a 1-month license. There's a few rules on how you can win those licenses. And as usual, quickly send an email to renderram.cgi@gmail.com. Whoever sends the email first will get a Scene Manager license. Whoever sends the email second will get a Project Dream license. Not only that, my face, as usual, this one will be hidden somewhere in the video. Whoever finds my face in the video, it's gonna be hard this time, so whoever finds it will get both Scene Manager and Project Dream license, like both licenses. The only thing that you need to do, just write down in the comments where you found it, and we'll see if you're the fastest or not. And for the remaining 2 licenses, I'm gonna be choosing a random person from the comment section. So one person will get a Scene Manager license and one person will get a Project Dream license. So say something nice in the comments and, you know, maybe a random generator will, you know, read your comments and he will be like, oh, this is a nice person, I'm gonna give him a Scene Manager or a Project Dream license. So the giveaway starts now, and please read all the rules in the description of this video. And yeah, let's continue. Okay, so this is generally where I'm at. So this is a little flower, this is what I got. Now from this point, I can just grab my image of the back and I'm gonna replace it with this one. And I'm just gonna toss it like in front of this whole thing, just to kind of see, you know, where the things are. I'm also just gonna rotate the candle holder just to look at the back. So these are the positions where it needs to be. Okay, so now I'm just gonna clone the flower and just position it where it needs to be. It's also slightly rotated, so I'm gonna also adjust that. Okay, just one important part. Since my polygons here that I have are generally much larger than the polygons on my flowers, so I kind of decided that I'm gonna just toss Turbo Smooth on top of everything just to kind of equalize the polygon size. And now I'm gonna be starting to actually connect all the pieces, because I was, you know, generally missing a lot of edges in count, you know? Okay, so now I got this generally ugly looking connection. It works, but, you know, let's try to make it pretty. And the thing that I like to always use is, you know, a little bit of this relaxed soften brush. Okay, so generally the modeling part is now done, and I can actually notice one thing. So this is like a pure back that we're looking at here, right? These, but I can see that my flowers are actually shifted. So a quick way to fix that, I'm just gonna select them and I pretty much just need to shift them. You see, like, this is the magic of this. You can just, you know, move things as much as you can and you're instantly seeing what's happening here, you know, like how much you need to move. So I pretty much missed by one row of polygons, and I'm just gonna delete that first row and I'm just gonna insert it here, and I'm gonna call this part pretty much done. And now just to add some final touches, and now you see how the whole thing is kind of curved here on the top. So what I can do now is just select the top row of polygons and just move it like this, and I'm just gonna move them kind of in, probably add one set of edges here just to kind of, you know, curve it a little bit. And from this point, I pretty much just added, you know, the thicknesses, etc. And now after a couple of, you know, final tweaks on adding thicknesses and connecting, you know, some bits, I'm pretty much done with this. My final object here looks like this. This is the part, by the way, that I generally forgot to record. At first, I thought I was done because I just pretty much, you know, had this front face and I had my flowers and then I added shell. But what happened is those flowers were kind of embossed on the inner side. And so I thought I was recording, but I wasn't. And yeah, I generally modeled this whole part. It's not perfect. You can see some imperfections here, but that's nothing to worry about. But in general, this is my modifier list and this is my object now. And, you know, as I was modeling, I was managed to kind of fine tune everything based on the images. And it's all thanks to the holy poly select plus bend, you know, feature. Like, just model everything on a straight plane and then just add the bend and you're pretty much, you know, like it's like easy sailing from that point. So yeah, maybe this will help you in your modeling journeys. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's video. And of course, don't forget to get some, you know, pulls discounts. Also, don't forget to, you know, participate. Maybe you win something. See you in the next video. Bye. Just a quick note, this contest is not sponsored by YouTube. I'm solely responsible for the contest and delivering the prizes to winners. Good luck.